How's it going, everyone? Chris from Automation, and today we're going to talk about the differences between Control4 versus Loxone and which one is better. So if you like the content and you enjoy the video, please feel free as usual to like and subscribe, and let's get into the video. So Control4 versus Loxone, which one is better? So when I'm talking to clients, the quickest way for me to round up the differences between Loxone and Control4, and also trying to understand what they prefer, is I ask them this. I say, Mr. and Mrs. Customer, are you looking for a smart home, which is more towards interacting with your home using touch switches, control panels, touch screens, through the remote on your phone, through the app on your phone or through remotes. So for an example, walking into a room, selecting the light switch, which lighting mood that you want, and then sitting down, in which case Control4 is probably a better option. Or on the other hand, are you looking for an automated home where you let the home take charge of everyday tasks, like for example the lighting? So in the same example, you walk into a room and rather than having to touch the wall or the touch switch or whatever, you walk into the room, the motion sensor picks you up and automatically brings on the right mood for that time of day, and based on the brightness level already in that room. And in that case, you're probably more suited towards Loxone. Now, this isn't to say that with your Loxone home, you can't interact through touch screens and switches and remotes and what have you. And in the same breath, you can't set up automated tasks with Control4. But out of the box, kind of without much programming, that's how the systems lend themselves. Control4 is more of a nicer experience when it comes to interacting with your home, and then Loxone is a better system for automating tasks. So this is how I would introduce the two systems, and then if the client was interested in hearing more, I would ask them two questions. So the first question would be, do you like the convenience of being able to watch TV in pretty much any room? And then if the answer was yes, I'd go on with the second question. Do you like the idea of being able to watch streaming services in every room, or Sky in every room, DVDs, your CCTV cameras, etc., in every room? And then usually the answer to this would be yes as well. If this was the case, then Control4 is definitely the better solution for this sort of video distribution. If the client wasn't bothered and was just happy having individual TVs with their own built-in streaming services alone from everything else, then I might say that the Loxone's a better solution, or you don't need to rely on Control4. Then the next questions I'd start to ask would be around their heating, ventilation and air conditioning, and what their requirements are. So in most cases, a client will tell me that they've got a gas boiler, typically maybe two, maybe three for the larger high-end residentials. And this would typically be used for the hot water. Maybe they're having air source heat pumps, ground source heat pumps for the central heating, with maybe the boilers as a backup, whilst having immersion heaters for the hot water backup. Then they might have a mechanical ventilation system with heat recovery, and then perhaps some more higher end homes would have AC as well. So you can just hearing about all that, it can get quite complicated, and physically trying to manage all of those systems harmoniously can be quite tricky. But with Loxone, this is kind of how Loxone was designed, as a building management system, and can take care of all these HVAC, so heating, ventilation, air conditioning needs, very, very easily, really. So yeah, if there's relatively complicated HVAC controls, similar to what I mentioned, then Loxone's probably the better solution, as it's more designed around building management and HVAC control, whereas Control4 is more of an AV control system. Now again, that's not to say that Control4 isn't able to do HVAC control, or maybe use something like KNX on the back end to control the HVAC, but generally it's more suited to an AV sort of solution, I would say. And then similar to what I said with maybe KNX being on the back end controlling the HVAC, and Control4 being on the front end, you could do exactly the same with Loxone. So Loxone controlling all the HVAC, so the heating, the ventilation, the air conditioning and everything in the plant, maybe managing some automation tasks as well, but then have Control4 on the front end, where the customer interacts with the system. So when they log into the app or use touch screens or remotes, they're seeing the Control4 user interface. Just a quick one, guys. If you spend any time on social media, in particular Instagram, feel free to go over and give us a follow. That's where we spend most of our time, and you can see what we're doing on a daily basis. So the next thing to talk about is media and cinema rooms. So if the client's interested solely in a media or cinema room, then Control4 is absolutely, hands down, the right choice to go with. And the reason for this is because Control4 has a huge driver database, and I'll explain what a driver is a bit later in the video. And this enables Control4 to integrate with AV systems or AV devices like TVs, projectors, AVRs, etc., etc., very easily. And because there's such a wide range of drivers available for Control4, it pretty much can integrate with anything. Whereas on the other hand, with Loxone, even though their driver database is growing, it's nothing compared to Control4. So what that would mean is most likely the driver would have to be written from scratch if you were using Loxone, which would take far more time and then could be prone to errors and not being as reliable as some of the drivers that have been written for Control4. So yeah, cinema room or media room, just on its own, Control4, 100%. Right, so let's tackle what a driver is. Bear with me for this. I'm reading from notes because I'll probably go all over the place if I don't stick to notes. So I'll try and be as concise as possible here. But in simple terms, a driver is basically code, which allows a control system like Control4 or Loxone to communicate with a piece of hardware or a device, like, for example, a TV. For example, if I wanted to switch on my TV through the Control4 or Loxone app, a driver would need to be installed, or it would need to be written specifically for that TV for this to be made possible. So then once this driver's been installed or written, this will then enable the communication from the control system, Control4 or Loxone, to go to that TV. Therefore, if I open the app and I press a button that says TV on, that will then go from the system, from the control system, across the network usually, to the device and switch it on. So that's what a driver is in simplistic terms. And there are various different types of mediums that these drivers can travel across. So most commonly it will be IP, so internet protocol, and then also IR, so infrared, and then maybe older devices might communicate on RS-232 or 485. That's typically what you'll have for AV control systems. And then for HVAC systems, you might have protocols like KNX, Modbus, or something like BACnet as well. So to conclude the original question, which was Control4 versus Loxone, which one is better? I'd say the answer is neither. It depends on what the client needs and what the client's preferences are. But to summarize the two systems, I'd say Loxone is better suited for building management and HVAC control, and Control4 is better suited for AV control and media and cinema rooms. Or best of both worlds, you'd have Control4 on the front end that the client interacts with through remotes, through tablet and phone apps, or touchscreens on the wall, and then you'd controlling the AV and maybe the cinema room, and then you'd have Loxone on the back end doing all the automation and control of the plant room and the heating, the ventilation, and the air conditioning. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did enjoy it, please feel free to give us a like and subscribe for more content. See you on the next video.